Back to my class. This is Dr. Rinsey Francis. Today's class is related with section 72A. What is 72A? This is part 4. Section 72A is discussed in this class. As per section 72A, if prescribed conditions are fulfilled, then loss of the amalgamating company shall be treated as losses of the amalgamated company for the financial year of merger. Hence, the loss can be adjusted in that year plus carried forward allowed for next 8 assessment year. This is the most important point related with the section 72A. First point is the loss of amalgamating company. The amalgamating company is treated. The loss of amalgamating company is treated as the loss of amalgamated company. Then second point is what it can be adjusted and carry forward for the next 8 assessment year. Then total 9 years we can enjoy the loss of the amalgamating company. Likewise, one is the financial year of the amalgamation. Financial year of the amalgamation. Amalgamation plus 8 successive previous years for next 8 assessment year. That means total 9 years we can carry forward the losses of amalgamating company. This is the condition under section 72A. Then what are the conditions to treat the loss of the amalgamating company as the loss of the amalgamated company? For first condition is they must belong to the prescribed sector. They must belong to the prescribed sector. Let's write down what are the conditions. First condition is it should be related with the prescribed sector. What are the prescribed sectors? Industrial undertaking. Then what next? Manufacturing sector. Manufacturing sector, then power, telecommunication sector, telecommunication, mining, then construction of ships, aircraft, railways, computer software, then ships, then industrial undertaking kanya, then ships, hotel companies, banking companies banking companies and their subsidiary banking companies with SBI. Banking merging of banking companies with SBI. With SBI. Then public sector airlines. Public sector airlines. These are the prescribed sectors. Once again, the first condition is it is should be related with belongs to prescribed sector. Prescribed sector means industrial undertaking, ships, hotel companies, banking, merging of banking with SBI, merging of public sector airlines, etc. Industrial undertaking means manufacturing sector, power, telecommunication, mining, construction of ship, aircraft, railway, computer software, everything is included. This is the first condition. Then second condition is 75% of the fixed asset. Second condition is 75% of the fixed asset. Fixed assets continue for next 5 years. Continue for next 5 years. Third condition is business should be continued. Business should be continued for next 5 years. Then fourth point is at least, that means minimum 50% installed capacity should be achieved by the end of fourth year, by the end of fourth and fifth year, by the end of fourth and fifth year. By the end of fourth and fifth year. Then fifth point is in genuine cases and unavoidable situations, central government may relax the provisions of achieving production level. That means there is a condition of minimum 50% installed capacity should be maintained at the end of the fourth and fifth year. So central government can give some relaxation. Central government may give some relaxation of the central government and certification. All these should be certified chartered accountant. These are the conditions of amalgamation under section 72A. Once again, let's conclude. Under section 72A, there are 2 points. First one is the loss of the amalgamating company is treated as loss of the amalgamated company. Then it can be set off of total 9 years. That means the financial year of the amalgamation itself plus next 8 assessment years. We can carry forward the losses of the amalgamating company. Then for that we have to follow 6 conditions. First condition is the company should be in prescribed sector. Then 75% of the fixed asset should be continued for next 5 years. The business of the amalgamating company should be continued for the next 5 years. Then minimum 50% of the installed capacity should be maintained at the end of the fourth, and it should be maintained at the end of the fifth year. That means fourth and fifth year we have to maintain minimum 50% of the installed capacity. Then relaxation may be given by the central government. Then last and but not least, we need a certification from the chartered accountant. These are the conditions. If we follow all these conditions, the loss of the amalgamating company is treated as loss of the amalgamated company. We can carry forward the losses for the next 8 assessment years. Thank you.